He's not a prince, he's not a king, he's not a work of art or anything. Not my words, but the words of my very special music guest tonight, Louise Wenner. As the face of Sleeper, she was there at the height of Britpop and knows her country house from her role with it. Now she's back with her first novel about a guy who wants a bit of fame himself. We'll talk books in a sec, but first, here's a musical flashback. He's not a prince, he's not a king, she's not a woman. Yeah, good outfit. How do you feel when you look back at those songs? Do you miss it?
I feel really nostalgic, actually. Yeah, I had all the moves, though. God.
You did have all the moves. You look excellent. And you were saying earlier that you thought what was great about the people who'd won Pop Idol, they'd go off and have the time of their life.
Yeah.
I mean, you said that it went a bit bad at the end, or there were good bits and bad bits. But would you agree that you just had the time of your life?
It was fantastic. We had 10 years, we went all over the world. And just going on Top of the Pops, that was something I dreamt about since I was a kid. It was great.
Yeah, that must have been fantastic. So how do you get from there to writing, let me just hold that up, a novel?
Well, someone asked me to write a short story after the band split up, and I really got bitten by the bug. And just started writing it, and I had the most fun doing it.
Isn't it such a, like, different... I mean, you couldn't get two more different professions, because one, I read a piece that you wrote, that, you know, you're on a tour bus, there's so many of you, and then you're on your own,
just in front of your keyboard, locked away in a room, but it's good, it's really nice, after doing creative things with other people for so long, just to have time to go and write yourself, it's really nice.
And it's so cool, because I've sort of written a novel and no one wants it.
and people really wanted yours. In fact, they wanted two. Have you? We'll read it out. We'll have readings. Louise, how do you make yourself do it? I mean, obviously you made yourself write songs, but does the discipline have to be very different?
It's the only time I've been disciplined my whole life. I get up at a certain time, write 1,000 words and don't stop until I've done it. And it's so different with your band. You sort of work all night, you get up when you want, there's someone to wake you up.
Someone to do everything for you.
You can get really, really lazy and spoiled. So.
Now, you're still with, and I believe living with, somebody who you're in the band with.
Yeah.
That's A, romantic, and B, does he find it very strange that he used to know Girl on Stage, Top of the Pops, to now, darling, I'm on word 800.
Yeah, he really likes it, because we used to work together and live together, which is quite difficult. So both doing completely different things at last, which is really nice.
Okay, tell us a bit about the book. What's it about?
It's about a group of three male friends, and they're in their late 20s, and they're still trying to make it in a pop band, and I write it as a man.
Yeah, why did you do that?
Because I didn't want to write the Sleeper story, I didn't want to write my story, and I wanted to write about... I spent a lot of the time in the back of a van with a bunch of guys, and I love the sort of humour and the camaraderie that you have.
What I love is the fact that those boys got groupies and you didn't.
I never got groupies.
But that's so unfair, don't you think, Mark?
Like,
the whole point is groupies. What kind of boys came up to you, if any?
You get sort of very sort of pale-faced, spotty boys, and they come and bring you poetry and say, please read this.
Oh, and what I love, my other favourite story, is that R.E.M. sang Happy Birthday to you.
Yeah, it was amazing.
See, that's got to be a good little moment in life.
It was great.
Did you get a really big advance for the novel?
No, not huge.
That's all right.
Good luck with it. Thank you for coming in and telling us. I spilt stuff on it. I'm not very good. Still to come, the Brits...